Hey y'all, in this video, I'm going to show you a quick little review of polynomials. We're going to be looking at the graph of a polynomial and then writing an equation based off of that. I've already done a detailed lesson on this, but I thought this might be something really good to go over and just review quickly just to kind of refresh your brains before the test. Before we get into this, I want to go over some parent functions just to kind of remind you of what's going on. My sketches are a little relaxed, but you get the point. So the parent function of this little curve here, this is a cubic function and its parent is x to the third. And then this middle graph is a quadratic, which is x squared. And then the last one is a linear, which is x. Now remember, these are the parent functions. So it's their children can look very different, but the parent function, the simplest function in its, or the function in its simplest form looks like this. And you might hear me refer to in my lessons, this has a jogging intercept. So it kind of like slowly goes through. And in polynomials, when you're looking at a bigger graph with different types of characteristics, if the function jogs through an x-intercept, then that's going to be associated with a third degree polynomial. Then if you have a quadratic, that's where it's going to kind of bounce off the x-intercept. That's going to follow the x squared. And then if you have a function that, or part of the function that goes directly through, straight through, like a linear function, then the parent of that is x to the first. So you kind of have to break down the polynomial and look at it a piece at a time and decide what the function is doing at that x-intercept. So your x-intercepts are going to shape your polynomial. This one down here, I just got a little sketch here. Just glancing at it, we can see that both ends, the end behavior, they're pointing up, same direction. So this is going to be an even degree polynomial, which means that all the exponents have to add up to an even degree. Then it looks like I've got two x-intercepts. One is at -1 and one is at 2. So those are my two x-intercepts. Now, before I can write my polynomial, I can get a framework for it. So I can say f of x, it's going to be positive because my endpoints are pointing up. I don't have to do a negative out front. I can do x plus 1, I know will be one of the factors, and x minus 2 will be the other factor. Remember, that comes from reversing this, where we add 1 to both sides, that gets the factor, minus 2 to both sides, that gets the factor. Now I need to figure out what are the exponents on those factors. I do know it's an even degree. And if I weren't given the graph, then that qualifies because 1 plus 1 is 2, even degree. But I was given the graph. And so I need to pay attention to the behavior of the graph at those points. At -1, my function jogs through, which mirrors a jogging x to the third. So that means I'm going to put a little 3 on that factor. It mirrors a cubic function. So that function by itself, when isolated, is third degree. Then if I isolate the next x-intercept, if I ignore the rest of the graph, if I discount all this and just isolate that part of the graph that I'm focusing on, it mirrors a linear function. It goes zoop, straight through. So the exponent on that factor would be a 1. We don't have to write the 1, but for the sake of the lesson, I'm going to write 1. Then when I add up my exponents, it should be even. If it's not even, then I've done something wrong. So 3 plus 1 is 4, even degree, 2 x-intercepts, positive coefficient, done. Hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please let me know. I'd be happy to help.